Hello, this is Wilter Nationals here. Imagine life just extinguished in the blink of an eye. Blinding flash of light, everyone's dead. The power of nukes are unimaginable. 20,000 tons of TNT. They destroy cities in seconds. They can be launched all over the world. They are an extremely terrible problem. They need to be fixed. Only certain countries have these nukes, but the technology is spreading, and we need to prevent the spread of that technology. Rogue states are obtaining such new technology as these nukes, claiming for peaceful goods, but they're using them for evil deeds. And when these evil things get in the wrong hands, bad things can happen. Bad people do bad things with these nukes. If they get in the wrong hands, bad things will happen. Terrorists would love to get their hands on technology such as this, so we need to prevent the spread of this technology. The development of these terrible weapons aroused during World War II with the Manhattan Project. Some of the world's greatest minds all gathered to create these travesties upon the world. Then after World War II, a bitter rivalry aroused between the USSR and America, which led to an arms race. Each of them developing better and bigger ones, more destructive and more powerful than ever. Since the Cold War, both Russia and America have both agreed that they don't want the technology to spread. That's why they signed the NPT back in 1968. The NPT would, in addition for countries agreeing not to develop their own nuclear programs, would receive peaceful nuclear technology. The five original nuclear powers were USSR, United States, United Kingdom, France, and China. But since then, three new countries have joined it. Israel, Pakistan, and India never even signed the NPT, but they've joined the nuclear club. And also, in 2003, North Korea has left the NPT and started developing their own technologies. The NPT wasn't the only peaceful solution that these two superpowers tried to take to stop the spread of this nuclear technology. They both took part in SALT. Strategic Arms Limitation Talks. Between these two superpowers are a bilateral talk that led to START, Strategic Arms Reduction Treaties. Now these treaties would reduce our strategic nuclear weapons by 3,000 by 2007. Now by strategic, they mean ICBMs, Intercontinental Ballistic Missiles. These missiles are long-range missiles. There's also SORT, or the Treaty of Moscow, which would cause our nuclear supplies between both Russia and us down to 17,000 to 2,200 by 2012. USSR and the United States have also been trying to put an end to nuclear testing. In 1963, they both signed the Limited Nuclear Test Ban Treaty. This treaty would allow testing underground, but prevented testing in atmosphere, in space, and underwater. There's also another test ban treaty, known as the Comprehensive Test Ban Treaty. This treaty was first signed by President Bill Clinton, and has hence been trying to get signed all across the world, but, sadly, it has still not been ratified by the United States, and eight other countries still have not signed it, and it can't go fully into effect until everyone signs it. This Comprehensive Test Ban Treaty would stop the testing of all nukes, even underground. And that also includes atmosphere, space, and underwater. With Obama trying to push for ratification of the CTBT, you may be asking yourself, what exactly can you do to help end nuclear proliferation? There's not much you can do on the personal level, but you can join an organization, and others just like you can help put an end to nuclear proliferation. Many organizations are promoting nuclear non-proliferation, and also promoting nuclear abolition. Some of the better organizations, such as the CND, or Campaign for Nuclear Disarmament, are promoting to non-violently rid the world of WMDs and wants to cooperate with other groups internationally for a greater mutual security. There's also the Center for Arms Control and Non-Proliferation. They want to reduce nuclear stockpiles and work to strengthen an international nuclear non-proliferation regime based on the NPT and halt the spread of WMDs. Then there's ICAN, also known as International Campaign to Abolish Nuclear Weapons. They wanted to demand an end to nuclear weapons through a nuclear weapons convention. They also opposed the creation of RRWs, or Reliable Replacement Warheads. There's also the IPPNW, or the International Physicians for the Prevention of Nuclear War, who campaigned to abolish nuclear weapons altogether, with that being their highest priority. Then there's NTI, Nuclear Threat Initiative. These people with different ideological views are working together to prevent global threats from attaining nuclear weapons. NTI is also working to develop a role to prevent dangerous nuclear material from entering terrorists' hands. Then there's Peace Action, who are working for a violent-free environment. What they do is they have been organizing grassroots networks to put pressure on Congress to promote their peace ways. If nuclear nonproliferation isn't promoted to its fullest extent, millions of lives will be lost. Terrorists will get their hands on this technology, and they will make a difference in the world for the wrong way. We need to end this now. We need to abolish nuclear technologies before a mushroom cloud ends it all.
Thank you. This has been Ultra Nationals Report.